Welcome here to KTM and welcome to the 1290 Super Duke R project, a motorcycle that was debuted at the Milan Motorcycle Show towards the end of 2012, and it stole the show because it is a game-changing motorcycle, full stop. Now with me here today is Jeremy McWilliams, the test and development rider for the entire project and a Grand Prix rider who has won races and been on the podium many a day. Jeremy, it's not just a very aggressive looking motorcycle, but all of the numbers, all of the impressive figures are inside that engine.
Yeah, phenomenal, Toby. The bike's producing 144 newton meters of torque, which is quite incredible. So that obviously equates into a very, very fun riding experience.
So, I mean, you can pull off in any gear, you can wheelie in any gear. This has got to be the torqueiest bike you've ever ridden.
It's got more torque than any bike I think I've ever ridden, and that's including all of my race bikes. So, yeah, second gear, pull away, third gear, fourth gear, wheelies if you so wished. Not that I told you that. It does make a lot of fun. Obviously, we've been doing it behind closed doors on a racetrack, so we've been able to do whatever we want with the bike. But it has been a very, very, very pleasurable experience.
A fun experience and a usable experience with a motorcycle that is super light as well. This is really something very, very different. A beast in terms of power, but certainly not in terms of handling. A KTM steel tubular chassis, single-sided swing arm, WP suspension, winning at Moto3 World Championship level. Jeremy, you had a clean sheet of paper, did you not, setting up this bike?
Yes, something very new to me. I had every geometry choice at my disposal, right down to damping rates, spring rates, even the ergonomic choice. The tire was designed around the motorcycle together with Dunlop.
Really?
And this is the complete package.
So nothing off the shelf. That's done many, many a kilometre already, has it?
We've used a lot of those tires to come up with this, but it works very, very well. It's the best.
And a tire that will work in all scenarios, whether or not you're going to the shops, or more importantly, going on that track day. A very powerful, a very torquey motorcycle that we've got in front of us. But that's down to the big V-twin engine in its heart. But electronics are very much part of the package as well. And they've come from Bosch. And they are here to assist the rider and certainly not to control them. Traction control and ABS. Jeremy, there are three rider mode settings with traction control. First off, street.
Street mode, the base setting, Toby. The rider shouldn't really feel any activation at any stage unless, of course, he steps over the limit. The throttle response is a little softer. Helps just that riding experience in town. He puts aggressive throttle openings into it, the bike takes care of it.
So it's nice and smooth.
Correct.
Then, of course, rain. With this much power, how does it cope with that?
The rain mode is pretty safe. I've got a lot of confidence in the rain mode. We've tried it on many different slippery conditions, and the system works quite cleverly, whereby it limits the maximum horsepower output. The throttle response is much softer. And of course, at minimal lean angles, we've got much more interruption from the traction control.
Sounds very safe. But what a lot of people want to know about is sport and what you're best at out there on the racetrack.
My favourite setting. We try to come up with a setting that was as close as possible to having no traction control on whatsoever. So it's a much more involved ride. The connection from the throttle to the bike is much more direct. We can get a little bit of spin, a little bit of slip at maximum lean angles, but not too much unless, of course, you overstep the mark, you overstep the limit. We get activation. But I really love the sport mode, and I think would be my preferred mode on the track. Rather than turning the traction control off, as you can, I would keep it in the sport mode.
These electronics enable this motorcycle to go from 0 to 200 kilometers an hour in under 8 seconds. And now we move on to stopping, braking, and specifically ABS. Jeremy, a couple of settings with the brakes?
Yeah, two ABS modes, one which is the standard, always maximum, shortest braking distance possible, and another mode where we have the possibility of disconnecting the rear wheel, so there's no ABS activating on the rear wheel for a more experienced rider, say he wants to slide about a little bit or whatever, or you could always switch it off.
For the brave. But in the normal ABS setting, can you beat it if the ABS is off?
Not a chance. We tried it a few times and I thought I could, but it always beats me, Toby.
Well, proof, if ever there was, that the electrics are always here to assist and not control. Other highlights include the lightest and the stiffest frame and swing arm in the entire class. The exhaust system, that's a lot closer to the rear wheel. What advantage does that give?
It was designed to give you more lean angle, Toby. That's why it's so close to the rear wheel.
A slipper clutch is standard, long service intervals with the V-twin engine, and an entirely new power parts package just for this bike so that you can customize it to exactly what you want. So the 1290 Super Duke R really does cover all bases, from the racetrack to the road, with everything in between. I'm rather envious. You must have had a bit of fun doing this.
Can you tell? I've ridden hundreds of motorcycles. This comes right at the very top of my wish list, Toby. It's been enormous fun developing the bike with the R&T department. And I've had a ball.
Now, if you want to know more about the 1290 Super Duke R, then log on to KTM.com.